en av de mest tongivarna inom då den tidiga pingströrelsen som Azusa Street utvecklades till. Hon heter Florence Crawford. Och hon har skrivit ett fantastiskt vackert vittnesbörd om hur hon mötte den helige ande och blev förvandlad helt och hållet. Hon skriver så här: "When I was a girl, brought up in a home of unbelief, never knew what it was to hear a mother pray, never laid my hand on a Bible till I was a grown woman, the God I served looked down into my heart and saw that I wanted something real. One night as I was dancing in a ballroom, I heard a voice speak out of heaven and said, 'Daughter, give me thine heart.' I did not know the voice of God the first time and I went on in the dance. But again the voice spoke from heaven and it seemed that heaven came down into that ballroom and my feet became heavy and the place was no longer beautiful to me. Again the voice spoke much louder, 'Daughter, give me thine heart.' The music died away and I left the ballroom and for 3 days and nights I prayed and wept and wrestled for my salvation. If ever I realized my soul was a sepulchre of dead men's bones, I did then. It seemed there was no hope for me, but I thought, why did God speak out of heaven if there were no hope? At last I remembered a woman I knew who was a Christian, and I went directly to her home. And when she looked into my face, she said, 'You want God?' I said, 'I want him more than anything else in the world.' I fell on my knees right there, and she prayed for me, and God came into my heart. Oh, it was wonderful, the rest, the peace, the quietness that flooded my soul. And as I wept for joy, I said, 'I must go and tell the others.' I went into the house where my friends were, waiting for me. They had cards on the table and ready to play. But I lifted my hands to heaven and said, 'No cards for me. I have found Jesus, whom my soul has hungered for so long.' When they looked at me, they saw the light of another world on my face. The cards were put away and we sang sacred songs, and oh, how God blessed my soul. The flowers went, the feathers and the fine clothes, everything I had loved that was of the world was taken out of my heart. But oh, how I loved lost souls and wept as I saw those who looked sad, and many times I would stop and tell them the story of Jesus. And when I heard that God could sanctify, for years I sought that experience. I went from place to place where they taught sanctification, willing to kneel at any altar, no matter how humble, if only I could find satisfaction to my hungry soul. When evangelists would come to the city, I would find my way to get a private interview with them, if possible, and told them my hunger. They would say, 'But you are sanctified.' But the hunger, the craving, the thirst that was in my heart, no human could know unless he had it. And while I laid a consecrated life, yet the fire had not fallen on the sacrifice. How I thank God when I heard of the latter outpouring of the Holy Ghost. He led me through that little mission at Azusa Street. It was not a fine hall, just an old barn-like building with only an old board laid on two chairs for an altar. The floor was carpeted with sawdust, the walls and beams blackened by smoke. I looked around to see if anybody saw me go in, but I would not have cared if the whole world saw me go out. I had found a people that had experience, that had the experience I wanted. The first hallelujah I heard echoed down in my soul. When I went out of there that day, I felt so little. The only thing I wondered was, can I ever get from Monday morning to Friday at 4 o'clock? I lay on my face between my duties. You can do your work and do it well and seek God too. I lay on my face and shed tears and read my Bible. And that Friday afternoon at the mission, the preacher stopped and said, 'Somebody in this place wants something from God.' I pushed the chairs away in front of me and fell at the altar, and the fire fell, and God sanctified me. The power of God went through me like thousands of needles." 3 days later, after living with Jesus alone, a great hunger seized me, and down I went before God. He showed me I must be baptized with the Holy Ghost and fire. He showed me that the temple was clean, that the Holy Ghost would come only on clean vessels, and how I pled with him and prayed and praised God and consecrated. I consecrated again deeper and deeper, and I sought for the power to tell the world what great things God has done for me. I sought till the following Friday. And then, as I sat in my chair in the mission, the Holy Ghost fell from heaven, and a rushing mighty wind filled the room. This tongue that never spoke another word but English began to magnify and praise God in another language. I was speaking in Chinese, and it was the sweetest thing I've ever heard in my life. The power of God shook my being, and the rivers of joy and divine love flooded my soul. It was so wonderful, but the greatest joy to my heart was that I had received the power to witness to lost souls, that they might find Jesus. I was a wreck in my body, but I never once thought of the healing of my body until God baptized me with the Holy Ghost and fire. I had worn glasses for years. 3 attacks of spinal meningitis early in my life had left my head and eyes so affected that I could not leave the glasses off. I went to the mission that afternoon and told what wonderful things the Lord had done for me and had them pray, and the healing power of the Son of God flowed through my eyes, and my eyes were perfect. I had lung troubles for years and had to live in Southern California for my health, and God healed me of that. I was thin, diseased, broken down in every part of my body, and when I had paid the full price and in simple childlike faith prayed that I might get my health back again and be a witness for him in this world, the healing streams began to flow. When a girl, I had been thrown from my carriage onto a jagged stump and lay at the point of death. Later in life, I had to wear a harness with straps and metal plate, and had never walked for 11 years without that harness. God instantly healed me. I walked 23 blocks at night, and I leaped and praised God. And I've praised God and given him the glory for his goodness to me for many years. The healing of my body was complete. An internal trouble the doctor said could not be cured without an operation was perfectly healed. Once diseased from the crown of my head to the soles of my feet, I was made sound and well through the blood of Jesus. The Christ of Calvary touched my body and made me whole. Oh, how I praise him, how I worship him for his great love to me. Do not be afraid to trust in God. His word is true. If you will pay the price, you can have the word wrought out in your life for healing, for sanctification, or anything you desire of him.